Hello guys, this is Revan from DJ Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 195. YouTube is testing a new feature that allows users to download videos on their desktop web browser. The latest feature is currently available as an experimental feature for premium subscribers. YouTube currently allows paid subscribers on Android and iOS to download content for offline viewing. This feature will only be supported in computer with the latest version of Chrome, Edge and Opera browsers. Both Vodafone Idea and BSNL lost active subscribers in the month of July 2021. Vodafone Idea's VLS subscribers percentage dropped from 88.43% in June to 87.67% in July 2021. While Bharti Airtel might not have as many as 4G subscribers as Jio, but it is still has more active subscribers than its competitors. Airtel focused more on quality while Jio mostly on numbers. According to the monthly performance report shared by Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, Airtel's 97.74% of users of total subscriber base were active as compared to rival Jio's 78.18% of the users of the total subscribers base. Even though Jio has added way more subscribers than Airtel in the month of July 2021, both the telcos had an identical number of active subscribers while Bharti Airtel had 346.07 million VLR subscribers, while Reliance Jio had 346.49 million VLR subscribers. While the BSNL VLR subscriber percentage dropped from 50.63% to 50.49%. The launch date for the Mark M3 smartphone has just been revealed. Mark is a sub-brand of the popular e-retailer Flipkart and offers various consumer electronic products and the home appliances. We can expect that this phone will be coming up with a 6.1 HD+ display with a water drop notch on the front where the selfie camera resides. And it is powered by a large 5000 mAh battery pack and offers up to 32GB of internal storage that can be expanded via microSD card slot. This phone will be launching on September 25th. The pricing is unclear, but it is hinted to be under the 10,000 Indian rupees price segment. IQ Z5 5G has been officially launched as a successor to the IQ Z3. The key IQ Z5 specifications include a 6.67-inch display, 120Hz refresh rate, and comes with a Snapdragon 778G chipset. IQ Z5 price starts at 1,899 Chinese yuan, that is approximately around 21,600 Indian rupees. Poco has tweeted the date and time for the upcoming launch. This launch is expected to be for a Poco C series smartphone. It will likely to be the last phone launched by the company for this year. The new Poco device will be making on its way on September 30th. From Xiaomi, it is going to launch a brand new Xiaomi Beard Trimmer 2 launching on September 29th in India. This beard trimmer will be having a all-new charging capabilities and a waterproof for the ultimate durability and a compact design with perfect ergonomics. Motorola has not released a new tablet in last 10 years, but the drought is about to end. Indian retailer Flipkart has revealed that the company will launch the Moto Tab G20 on September 30th. This tablet will be aimed mostly at kids who will use it for school work and entertainment. It will run near stock Android 11 with kids mode, and it will have a metal body which should make it quite durable. It will be having an 8-inch IPS LCD panel with a Dolby Atmos audio. Android will be running on Helio B22T chipset and comes with a 3GB of RAM and a 32GB of storage. Samsung Galaxy F42 5G has been officially confirmed for September 29th. This device will go on sale via Flipkart during the Big Billion Day sale. Samsung Galaxy F42 5G is said to come with a 90Hz Full HD+ display, 12 5G bands and a 5000 mAh battery. Redmi will be launching Redmi 9 Active and 9A Sport in India. Redmi 9 Active and 9A Sport will be based on Redmi 9 and 9A. Redmi 9 Active and 9A Sport will come in a metallic purple and metallic blue colors. And moreover, Redmi 9 Active has been listed on Amazon with the complete specifications. Redmi 9 Active shipped with a MediaTek Helio G35 chipset, a 6.53-inch display with a standard 60Hz refresh rate and a 13-megapixel dual camera. Redmi 9 Active will be on sale in India starting from tomorrow on September 24th. Honor has scheduled a launch event in China for September 26th. Honor has been gradually revealing the devices that will be announced at the conference for the past few days. Today, the Honor has confirmed that the new version of Honor MagicBook Pro 16 will be debuting at this event. Huawei has initially announced the Open EULAR program back in 2019 as an open source operating system and released the 20.03 LTS edition last year. Now the Huawei is gearing up for the launch of new Open EULAR OS that is set to be announced on September 25th. The upcoming Open EULAR operating system is an open source and free Linux distribution platform that will offer an open community for developers across the globe. Battleground Mobile India has permanently banned around 59,247 accounts from the September 10 to September 16. Vivo is apparently working on a new unique smartphone. This company has patented a device that features a detachable pop-up camera mechanism that houses camera sensors on the front and back. The Chinese smartphone maker filed a patent with the World Intellectual Property Organization that was published earlier this month. This patent describes a smartphone with a pop-up camera mechanism on the top right corner. While the pop-up camera usually houses a camera module for taking selfies, this version also houses a dual camera on the rear that functions as a primary rear sensor. iPhone 13 lineup is finally here and it comes with the same prices as the last generation depending on where you are. iPhone 13 prices can go up to almost $3,000 in some countries, according to the new research shows. According to the research, how many hours people need to work to buy a brand new iPhone 13 in different regions around the country. Samsung launches a two new flagship smartphone lineups, the Galaxy S series in the first half of the year and the Galaxy Note series in the second half of the year. However, this time, the company confirmed that it is not launching a Note series device. According to the tipster, the Note series is gone for good and the upcoming Galaxy S22 Ultra will take its place. It has been just said that phone will not quite similar to the Galaxy Note 20U and will come with a built-in S Pen. Realme GT Neo 2 India launch has been officially confirmed by the company CEO Madhav Seth. This handset debuted in China earlier this week. Realme GT Neo 2 price in India is expected to be around ₹30,000. If we talk about the specifications, it comes with a 6.62-inch Full HD plus 120Hz AMOLED display, Snapdragon 870 processor and up to 12GB of RAM. It will be coming up with a 64MP triple camera with a 5000mAh battery, which supports a 65W fast charging. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.